Hello students, I am Subodh Vijay, the Maths faculty. Today I will discuss the solution methods of quadratic equation. As in the previous class, we have discussed how to recognize the quadratic equation. Now in this class, we will discuss the solution methods. In the last class, I told you there are three methods of solving quadratic equation. First of them were MTS, middle term splitting. It is also known as factorization. So it can be understood by one example. Or two example. So first example is x square minus 5x plus 6 equals to 0. So first of all, on the left hand side, we have to write the its constant term into coefficient of x square. So what is the constant term? That is c, that here it is 6, and the coefficient of x square is a, here it is 1. So we'll write 6 into 1 on the left hand side. Now we have to factorize that, that is 2 into 3 into 1. And see over here, before the constant term, what is the sign? Is it plus or minus? So this is plus here. So we need sum of these factors, pair of these factors. Sum must be equals to this coefficient of x, 5. So we will divide these factors, in the form that its sum is 5. So 2 plus 3 equals to 5. Now we have to replace this 5 by 2 plus 3. So x square minus 2 plus 3 in bracket, x plus 6 equals to 0. Now we will open this bracket, x square minus 2x minus 3x. We have to keep attention on this minus also. Plus 6 equals to 0. Now we will take pairwise common by these four terms. So from first two terms, x is common. When x is common, we will write it in the left part, that is x minus 2. From last two terms, minus 3 is common. So left part is x minus 2. So x minus 2 minus 3, x minus 2 equals 0. These two brackets must be same. Otherwise, we are doing some mistake. Now these two brackets are same, so it can be taken common. X minus 2 is common in the next step. So here, if x minus 2 is common, the left part is x minus 3. So x minus 2 into x minus 3 equals to 0. Here, these two brackets, product of these two brackets is equals to 0. It means either this bracket is 0 or this bracket is 0. So we will write it equals to 0 separately. X minus 2 equals to 0, it gives the value of x, that is 2. Or x minus 3 equals to 0, it will give x equals to 3. So these are two solutions of this equation, the values of x. Now another example on the right hand side, 3x square minus 4x minus 7 equals to 0. So in the same manner, we will take coefficient of x square 3 and constant term 7 on the left hand side, and we have to find their difference. As the sign before the constant term is minus, so we have to take the difference. We have to take the difference so that its difference must be equal to the coefficient of x, that is 4 here. So obviously 7 minus 3 is 4. Now we will replace this 4 by 7 minus 3 in the next step. So next step will be 3x square minus bracket 7 minus 3 bracket closed, x minus 7 equals 3. Further step will be to open this bracket, 3x square minus 7x plus 3x minus 7 equals to 0. Now same pairwise common. So from first two terms, x is common, left part 3x minus 7. From last two terms, there is common, no value is common, so we can take 1 as common. So in the bracket 3x minus 7 equals to 0. Now these two brackets are same, so we can take it common. 3x minus 7, left part is x, here plus 1 equals to 0. So 3x minus 7 into x plus 1 equals to 0. Either this bracket is 0 or this bracket is 0. So we will put them separately, equals to 0. 3x minus 7 equals to 0. It will give the value of x, that is 7 upon 3. From here, x plus 1 equals to 0, x will be equals to minus 1. So friends, I hope that you have clearly understood the Amplius method of solving quadratic equation.